chicks! Welcome to the Arbonne Reality Show. The Arbonne Reality Show starts today. And what it is going to be small snippets of video of me working my business from my desk. Now, obviously, you won't see my presentations, but I don't know, maybe I'll bring a camera one of these times. But I had an idea, and the idea was, what if I pretended I was starting my business from scratch? And if I could show you what I do in the course of my day, would that be of benefit to you? So I'm going to do it, and we're going to give it a try. I'm going to do this for 90 days, which means that you're going to get videos of me in small snippets that say, this is what I've done. And hopefully, all you have to do is mimic those same steps to have the same success in your business. Okay, so what you're going to get is honest-to-goodness raw Genevieve, which means that sometimes you're going to see me as I'm working my business without makeup, having just worked out, kids will walk in and out. I want you to get a real dose of what it's like to work an Arbonne business from my perspective. So let's do it together, let's rebuild, and let's make sure that everybody's making a little money. There's a lot of people out there that need some help, and the faster you build your business, the faster you can teach other people to do the same. Okay, let's have a frank little discussion about these six classes, shall we? Believe it or not, I'm going to do six classes this month, and I'm going to let you watch me ask people, schedule dates, do all that kind of fun stuff. The first thing that you need to understand is that I didn't always do six classes a month, and I really wasn't very good at scheduling classes. And if I can figure it out, you can figure it out. Once I did figure it out, though, you guys, I found out that I spent a lot less time on my business because I wasn't trying to fill in with volume. I found that I moved super quickly. I found that I found people to do the business with me much faster. And believe it or not, I worked my business in a lot less time. So if you need help booking presentations, make sure you contact me or contact your upline and take a good look at how I make my phone calls so that you can see if there's something that you are doing that perhaps isn't working for you or something that I'm doing that you can implement. So I know you can get six classes. You just have to decide that you're going to do it this month. Hang on, my daughter's talking. Now, since I don't have all of my classes, I have four, and I've already had one presentation already, I'm going to spend a majority of my time booking two more classes. So I don't do anything else until I have six presentations on my calendar. And just to be clear, a presentation in my book has a hostess other than myself, is conducted at someone else's home other than my own, and the hostess does the guest inviting. That is my parameter for a party. Other things that you do, girls' night outs at schools, things at salons, whatever, those may all add value to your business, but they aren't really things that are proven to give you the success that you're looking for. So you can do them in addition, just know that they don't count as one of your six presentations. Now, the other two things that I have on my calendar that are kind of Arbonne things but aren't part of presentations are, I have a girls' night out at a school, like I talked about, and then I also have a one-on-one makeup consultation. So I have a couple other things on my calendar as well, but I'm still going to get my six parties. Oh, I just realized that I'm recording with these dead flowers behind me. That's because those are the flowers that I got from Arbonne for my birthday. And my kids didn't think I wanted to throw them away, so they just put them in my office. And I haven't cleaned my office yet, so they're sitting there kind of like Morticia Adams. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you about the flowers. My daughter's now moving my flowers. Okay, anyway, here's the big deal. If you get up in the morning and think you're going to always feel like doing Arbonne, you got to know that you're just not. You got to get on the clue bus about that. There are days that I get up and I just really am too tired, too overworked, too busy, a little discouraged, whatever it is. Everybody's got reasons for not feeling like working Arbonne. The antidote to that for me is to be able to switch modes. And the way that I switch modes is by listening to something about my business for 30 minutes a day. And I usually do that in the shower. So today I listened to The Magic of Thinking Big, and it was a really great session. There was really good stuff in there. It really motivated me to want to work and get stuff done today. So I highly recommend, if you're not already, that you find some business piece of information and either read or use your dead time in the shower and while you're getting ready for the day to go ahead and do your self-development. Okay, and every day we're going to have something that things that make you go, hmm. And I got my hmm from something I was listening to in my 30 minutes of self-development. So I want to play that for you. Hopefully I can do it in one clip. I might have to do it in two.
Your mind is a thought factory. It's a factory that produces thousands of thoughts each day. There are two foremen in charge of your factory. One of them is named Mr. Triumph, and the other is named Mr. Defeat. Mr. Triumph is in charge of manufacturing positive thoughts. He specializes in producing reasons why you can do things, why you're qualified, why you will succeed. Mr. Defeat is in charge of negative thought production. He's your expert on developing reasons why you can't succeed. You don't feel like dealing with customers. You have a headache. Your wife or your husband was in a bad mood this morning. Mr. Defeat is amazingly efficient. In just a few minutes, he's done his job so well that you're completely convinced that this is a really bad day. But now tell yourself, this is a fine day. And this time, Mr. Triumph is signaled into action. And he tells you, yes, indeed, it's a wonderful day. The weather's refreshing. It's good to be alive. You can catch up on all that work today. It's a pleasure to be doing business on a day like this. And before you know it, it is a good day. Mr. Defeat will tell you why you can't land the Mortimer account. Mr. Triumph will tell you why you can. Mr. Defeat will tell you why you don't deserve the promotion and why you shouldn't even bother to try for it. Mr. Triumph will show you why no one else on earth is more qualified for that job than you are. Mr. Defeat will help you prepare a brilliant case against the guy you work with. He'll show you why he's impossible to be around and how he makes your life miserable. Mr. Triumph will show you his positive qualities and help you find ways to make your association with him succeed. The more you work with either of these foremen, the stronger they become, and the more space they take up in your mind. If you give Mr. Defeat your thought factory, he'll take up more and more of the space, so that eventually your thought factory is producing nothing but negative thoughts. But if you give Mr. Triumph the work, then your thought factory will produce the thoughts that will propel you towards success. In fact, you can fire Mr. Defeat. You'll discover that you really don't need him at all. You can use Mr. Triumph 100% of the time and produce only positive, productive thoughts. The result of this kind of thought production is the most basic ingredient in personal success, self-belief.
So anyway, I thought that was interesting. I hope you did too.